Good evening. A high-ranking Comanchero and his brother have been ambushed at an Auburn gym. Hit in a hail of bullets, innocent people cowering where they could. Tariq Zahed is in a serious condition in hospital, his brother Omar killed at the scene. And tonight, the revelation from police, both men had been warned.
Two brothers down and bloodied, belted with bullets in the foyer of Body Fit Gym. One of them captured convulsing on the ground before paramedics and police swarm, working on the floor in shattered glass.
I see them on the ground, on the floor, and they get shot on his head. Very crazy. I think he got more than 20 bullets. I just tried to hide myself behind the treadmill until everything is done.
Comanchero Sergeant-at-Arms Tariq Zahed is left in a critical condition, shot and lying in an ambulance while his brother Omar dies inside. Gunmen ambushed the iron-pumping gangsters about 8 last night, firing up to 20 shots in their direction.
The two brothers who were involved in this incident were warned as of last Thursday that their lives were at risk.
Last night, the killers fled the pandemonium on Parramatta Road before heading to Greenacre, where things slowed down. A masked man tosses a Molotov cocktail at one of the getaway cars and jumps back. He misses, scrambling around to the other side where he drops it into the passenger window before...
Wow.
Earlier, the executioners torched another getaway car at Baralla.
Ripper.
I think someone threw something in there and, boom, off it goes.
Nine News knows Zahed well, the bikie with an affinity for designer clothes, hamming it up for our cameras outside a Sydney court last year. Shortly before he was arrested for assaulting a bikie affiliate inside the bathroom of a swanky restaurant at Crown's Barangaroo Casino. Always under watch, he and his slain brother Omar were nabbed breaching lockdown orders walking the Bay Run at Drummoyne in the middle of the night last August. And in September last year, he flew to Lebanon, claiming he feared for his life, returning several months later to Melbourne, where he put the spotlight on himself by interrupting play during the Australian Open men's final. Since the 90s, Tariq's been charged with more than 40 offences. Tariq had plenty of enemies and plenty of people who wanted him dead, but he still came here to this known Comanchero hangout, a fishbowl, for those who targeted him. The father of four had a well-publicised bounty on his head, just as gangster Mahmoud Brownie Ahmed did before his execution at Greenacre just 2 weeks ago.
That's one of Lyon's inquiry. Look, we can't discount any of those links or conflicts at the moment.
Today, detectives back at the suburban gym scouring for anything the killers may have left behind.
We can't discount an internal conflict either. Obviously, with all these shootings and people are being killed, there's opportunities for people to try to take their place.
Our senior crime editor, Emma Partridge, is at Westmead Hospital tonight. Emma, you have an update on Tariq Zahed's condition.
Pete, we understand Tariq Zahed is currently undergoing a second round of surgery as we speak after he was shot in the face but remains in a critical but stable condition. Tonight, Pete, detectives are still hunting for the shooters, but it's difficult to pinpoint who is behind this because Tariq was involved in many conflicts, including in his role as a Comanchero, but also because he's linked to the Alamedine crime family who are engaged in a bloody gangland war. And Pete, it's an impossible situation for police to figure out quickly, as Damien Ryan explains.
Another gangland hit met by tough talking.
We are going to hunt you down.
And a new crack squad to lead the investigation.
Today I can announce that Strike Force Leary is going to be established.
Last night's ambush of the Zahed brothers is a carbon copy of the many gangland-style shootings in recent years. None more so than the 2018 assassination of Mick Howie. Like Tariq Zahed, he was a boss of the Comancheros and gunned down leaving a gym. Only yesterday, the new police commissioner, approaching 100 days in the job, was upbeat on gang crime.
I'm confident we will see a resolution.
And was satisfied enough resources were being thrown at the problem.
Well, yeah, we've got plenty of resources. We're just adding in resources.
24 hours later, 30 extra officers are rushed into the gang-busting Raptor squad.
Have you lost control?
No, not at all.
We can't have a situation where the criminals are sorting things out amongst themselves. You've had 12 murders, 12 killings since June 2020. Absolutely unacceptable.
The swift decision to bolster the ranks of Raptor comes as senior police are under increasing pressure to break the cycle of shootings and murders before an innocent person becomes a victim. In the mid-2000s, the newly formed Middle Eastern Organised Crime Squad took the gangs head-on and won.
We need to get right in their face. A lot of these people, they have no respect for law and order in this state.
Today, the lawmakers turn back the clock.
We will actually kick down doors, we will raid homes, we will raid businesses, we will harass you, we will disrupt your everyday life to stamp this kind of activity out.
Damien Ryan, 9 News.